to know this life. Open us to your love, to your acceptance, to your forgiveness, to your peace. Open us to one another and to the possibility you have in store for us. Give us the hope for the future and a passion for life here and now. We pray in the name of the Lord and the one who destroyed death, Jesus Christ and our Savior. Amen.
Amen. Service today. We will not be responsible for how they look on next Sunday. Lebanese. So while they are bright and white, we encourage you to take them home and enjoy them.
Amen.
The church office will be closed on tomorrow, that is April 18th, in observance of the holiday today. And so we will reopen on Tuesday, April 19th at our regular scheduled hours. And I also had a blast over this weekend. This has been a great
Amen.
Weekend for me. The Easter holiday weekend is always an exciting time, and I will tell you all, I enjoy the New Beginnings United Methodist Church Easter egg hunt.
Man.
You were here for the Easter egg hunt yesterday. Let me just make some noise.
Amen. Amen.
Great prizes, with a great ministry and reach outreach opportunity for our neighborhood kids and our
Amen.
Grandkids and nieces and nephews and cousins who all came in to support yesterday. And so for all of you who gave prizes, who gave cash donations, who cooked food, who showed up, who helped me sort through prizes and then draw lines and then figure out everything out, thank you all so much. I want to thank Sister Myra and the entire Children and Youth team for helping put it together.
Wow.
I had a blast, but I know I did. So thank you all. The church is still accepting Lenten offerings. We know that throughout the season of Lent, we were preparing our offerings. And when we collect our offering today, we're encouraging all of our members and friends who have been making that sacrificial offering, preparing that, to please be prepared to render those offerings at the end of service today. Please check your calendars for upcoming meetings. There are a couple listed on our bulletin. I will not go through all of them. This morning, I do want to ask, while we are together, are there any special prayer requests? I received one that came in this weekend. We are praying for Zion Callens. He's a grandson of Ms. Brenda Spencer. They had to airlift him to Children's Hospital in Jacksonville, Florida on Friday. And so we are keeping him lifted in prayer. Pray for our family during this time.
Geraldine Shepherd.
Sister Geraldine Shepherd.
The Murphy family.
The Murphy family.
The Jenkins family.
The Jenkins family.
Father Clarence Williams.
Clarence Williams. Clarence Williams.
Sharon Benson.
Sharon Benson.
The Hurd family.
The Hurd family.
The Key family.
The Key family.
Annette Shepherd.
Annette Shepherd.
Carla Lester and Rhonda Bell.
Carla Lester and Rhonda Bell. Kate Bell.
Jacqueline Hubbard.
Jacqueline Hubbard.
Cassandra Barbemere.
Cassandra
Barbemere. Barbemere.
Barbemere.
Barbemere.
Barbemere.
The Howard family.
Howard family. We want to also remember all those who are printed on our bulletins who are listed among our known, sick, and shut-in members. We still believe that the effectual, fervent prayers of the righteous avail much, able to cover a multitude of illnesses, challenges, transitions in our world. And so we want to keep all of those who have been listed this morning on our prayer list lifted in prayer. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. I'm going to invite all who are able to please stand to your feet as we prepare for our call to worship this morning. Our call to worship will be led by Ms. Ashley Smith.
God is good
all the time
and all the time.
God is good.
Give thanks for the Lord, for God is good. Let all the people proclaim God's steadfast love endures forever.
God's steadfast love endures forever.
The Lord is my strength, my song, and my salvation. Shouts of joy resound in the tents of the righteous.
God's steadfast love endures forever.
The Lord's right hand has done mighty things.
We will not die for the living. We will proclaim what the Lord has done.
We enter the gates of the Lord and give thanks, for this day the Lord has done.
own wealth.
Amen. to just testify the goodness of the Lord. And to express their love and adoration of God in their own special way. Our next group is coming, and they have put together a dance just to celebrate the story of the Lord and the blood that saves us all. Come on up, ladies.
Many different religions and so many different churches. And if God really loves me, then why does life keep hurting me? If you've ever asked any of these questions, well, my friend, I've got the answer. Just listen.
You have the power to make the seasons change. The wind whispers your name. For me, you left your throne and traded crown for thorns instead. I'm safe within, not by your skin, but because your blood was red.
Yeah.
Amen. Amen.
Let's give him another hand. So proud of them.
Amen.
They learned in about a week and a half. They've been working hard.
Yeah.
I love seeing them dance in the Lord's house.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Well, I'm going to invite you to stand with all those across the world who are affirming their faith in God this morning. And so if you're able, please stand with us for the affirmation of faith. It is printed inside of your bulletin. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. You may be seated.
Thank you.
our prayers of confession. They are printed in our bulletin and are to be read together. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be an obedient church. We have not done your will. We have broken your law. We have rebelled against your love. We have not loved our neighbors, and we have not heard the cry of the needy. Forgive us, we pray. Free us for joyful obedience. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We invite you now to confess your personal sins before the Lord. Beloved, hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love towards us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen.
Amen.
Our scripture lesson this morning will be read the Old Testament by Isaiah Cook and the New Testament by Morgan Wright. You may come in that order.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Our Old Testament scripture lesson comes from 118th division of the book of Psalms, verses 1 through 2 and verses 14 through 24. Hear the word of the Lord, the Psalm of Victory. Oh, give us thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. The Lord is my strength and my might. He has become my salvation. There are glad songs of victory in his tents of the righteousness. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. The left hand of the Lord does exalted. The right hand of the Lord does valiantly. I shall not die, but shall live and recount the deeds of the Lord. The Lord has punished me severely, but he did not give me over to death. Open to me the gates of the righteousness, that I may enter through them and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord. The righteous shall enter through it. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builder rejected and has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Our New Testament scripture lesson comes from the Gospel according to St. Luke, the 24th chapter, verses 1 through 12. And it reads, but on the first day of the week, at early dawn, they came to the tomb, taking the spices that they had prepared. They found the stone rolled away from the tomb. But when they went in, they did not find the body. While they were perplexed about this, suddenly two men in dazzling clothes stood beside them. The women were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground. But the man said to them, why do you look for the living among the dead? He is not here, but he has risen. Remember how he told you while he was in Galilee that the Son of Man must be handed over to sinners and be crucified, and on the third day rise again. Then they remembered his words,
And returning from the tomb, they told all these to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene, Joanna, Mary, the other mother of James, the other women with them who told this to the apostles. But these words seemed to be an idle tale, and they did not believe them. But Peter got up and ran to the tomb. Stooping and looking in, he saw the linen cloths by themselves. Then he went home amazed at what had happened. This is the word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God. Amen.
I want to invite our children coordinators to prepare our children for their Easter recitations. I was grateful to hear that some of them would be coming together and prepare a recitation for this morning that they would give in service. So all those who have Easter recitations, if you would please make your way to the front while our choir blesses us with another selection.
Thank you.
choir that sang that song. You should have been on your feet. Children have prepared recitations to present in the house of the Lord as worship this morning. And so, if I can manage to not mess up names, I'm going to call them forward. If you all will meet me right down here in the middle, we will hear our Easter speeches this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Say preach. Say birthday and preach.
I might need to. Y'all start praying. I know what praying will do.
Let's give all of our children a hand. And speak, I was invited as a guest while in college attending Morehouse. And it was a Good Friday service. And they gave me the opportunity to choose which of the seven last sayings that I would be able to elaborate or expound upon. And I remember distinctly my favorite of the seven last sayings. And it was the words, it is finished.
Mm. It's good, it's good.
It is finished. Mm. Now some read the seven last sayings and they say, how is it that Jesus is able to stand on the cross and speak the words, it is finished, and there is still more life left in his body and work to do.
Well. Mm.
And for those of us who try to, you know, lay parallels in our mind and try to come to grips with understanding what those words finish mean, we know that the word finish is often associated with something being completed. And at times, we don't say something is finished or complete because we don't see that the process is over and done.
All right. Amen. Amen.
However, I can imagine that for Jesus, who had come down from glory, been born of a virgin, who had showed up at the Jordan River, allowed himself to be baptized and submitted to a process that was truly beneath him.
All right.
That after walking from town to town, healing the sick, teaching those who were lost, helping them to understand the ways of God, that after he had done all of these things, feeding the 5,000, feeding 4,000, raising a daughter from the dead, stopping the woman's blood who had the issue of blood.
Yes, sir.
Standing before leaders and declaring that I'm here to save the least and the lost. After standing on the Mount of Olives and teaching lesson after lesson to people, some who would get it and some who wouldn't.
All right.
Visiting the tomb of Lazarus and saying, come forth.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
That after all of these things and after toiling with 12 disciples and seeing them multiply as he went from town to town, village to village, after seeing him walk on water, these same disciples who were his closest sat down with him to celebrate the feast of the Passover, and when he had completed the meal, he told them of a time when he would have to die. Now, because I have read that portion of the story, when I get to the point where he is on the cross saying it is finished, I understand that he is coming to a point that he has already recognized and prophesied that it's going to be taking place. And so I am able to understand that the process that needs to be completed isn't one that has to be done in front of everybody else, but it's one that has to be done in my mind, in my heart, and by faith.
Amen.
Because when I have purposed in my mind that I'm going to give my life over and let myself be given as a sacrifice for others, before you see me drop my head into the lock of my shoulder, before you see the blood and water come pouring out of my side, before they take me down and place me in a borrowed tomb, I've already decided that this is what it's going to be, and the work is already done. Now, this is my favorite of the last sayings, not because it is prophetic and it is elusive and poetic in all these different ways. It's my favorite of the last sayings because Jesus is the answer to over 400 years of prayer. Because there were hundreds and thousands of people who were waiting on the manifestation
because he had purposed that it would be so. It is my favorite of the last sayings because I realized that when he said it is finished, he was the answer to a promise. And so when these women on the day of resurrection come to the tomb and they look inside and they see that he is not there. The Bible says that these two beings show up to them and says, don't you remember how he said while he was yet in Galilee? And in this moment, there is this drawing of responsibility to realize that there was a time when you had every bit of understanding that you needed to know what this process was going to look like and what was going to happen in the end. The same way it was promised to the prophets for 300 and 400 years, the same way that it was foretold as he sat down with his disciples, the same things that you had in your memory, the promises of God can be recollected, put together, remembered so that you understand that before you see the end, it's already finished and promised for you. I get excited when I read those words, it is finished, because I realize that what is in that tomb and what died on that cross was not just for everybody else, but it was also for me. I get excited because I realize that when Jesus said it is finished, he had already decided to be the sacrifice that would save me from my sins last month, last year, last night, and next week. I get excited because when Jesus said it is finished, he already knew that I was going to fall short of the glory of God. And he was already feeling it that I would have an opportunity to get it right. And so when I come to that place on Resurrection Sunday morning and I remember the words, it is finished, and I'm looking into the empty tombs of my life, I realize that although I don't see the manifestation of everything God has said, it's already said and done because God has finished the work that he has promised to me. Some of us have to stop getting so overwhelmed and so disillusioned and so frustrated and so downcast just because we don't see things working out the way we want them to. Some of us, like the first disciples, are running and hiding because they've arrested our Savior, and the hope that we saw and walked with and believed in looks like it's going to be defeated. But he said it is finished even before the process has fully begun. So when I look on that resurrection morning and I see my Savior walking in the garden again, I realize that as a child of God, other folks can't stop my blessing. I realize that as a child of God, that even my doubt and my fears can't stop my blessing. That what God has for me and has promised for me, it is finished and it is mine. So when they were talking about me, resurrection was still mine. When they were hanging him on the cross, it's all right because resurrection still belonged to him. When they were piercing him in the side, it's okay because the resurrection was already promised for him. You see, if Jesus had to go through some trials and some tribulations, had to be ridiculed and persecuted, then some of us are going to have to go through the same thing. But while we're going through, you've got to remember that if Jesus got up, you can get up too. Because the same promises that were flowing down from Calvary's mouth 2,000 years ago are still flowing into my heart and my mind and my house today, and it's flowing into yours too. If you can remember the words that he said while he was yet in Galilee. The words that he promised to those who would walk by faith. Words like, I will be with you, even unto the ends of the world. Words like, I will not leave you nor forsake you. I'm sending you a comforter. Words that say, my word shall be a light unto your feet, a lamp unto your path. Words that are promised to you that are finished and sealed if you would just wake up and receive.
My Lord, my Lord.
They're yours. They're yours. They're yours. They're yours.
Thank you, Lord.
Stop going to the places where your words and your memory has disappeared. It's not in the tomb anymore.
promise that God has for you is up, alive, walking, and well, and is ready to bless you and show you just who God is and what God can do. But you're still looking for the promises of God in dead places that God has already removed them from. Hoping that the same ones who cursed you are going to be the ones that come back and bless you. No, God has come out of that tomb and moved on to somewhere else. Don't let God bless you somewhere else. Wanting the same people who have dismissed you and looked over you for years to come back and validate you and tell you that you're good enough. Come out of that tomb. He's not there. He has risen, and to tell you that you were made in the image and likeness of a powerful and wonderful God. You were fearfully and wonderfully made. There is no mistake about you. God loves you, and you can come out of that tomb and walk in the victory of God. Head, not the tail. Come out and walk in the victory of God. These things cannot be taken from you despite what you go through. Despite the circumstances of our world and the lives that we live. Because they were promised. And it is finished. You got to show up and receive it. Beloved, we are here to celebrate.
Yes, sir. Yes,
to
yes.
Celebrate.
Yes.
Our hope and our deliverance came from a God that is not confounded by the things of this world.
Amen.
The supernatural power and love of God is greater than any disappointment or failure of people. And so when folk don't show up like you want them to, trust in God. That's what we celebrate on Resurrection Day. There were hundreds of prophets who did not and could not get the people of God right, but Jesus came himself and completed the work because God wouldn't let the people of this world stop his promise for redemption.
Amen.
God is continually reaching for us, showing us that God loves us.
Yes, Lord.
God wants to help us and bless us.
Yes, Lord.
Your help and your hope is here.
Yes, Lord.
Because God has said it is for you.
Yes.
It is finished.
Yes, Lord.
It is finished. Amen. Receive it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
Let us prepare our hearts to receive the sacrament of Holy Communion. It is a gift and a privilege that God extends to us because God loves us so much. It is the outpouring of God's care and compassion for people who don't deserve to receive it. But yet and still, he gives it because he wants us to have it. So if you are here today, the table is prepared, but salvation is also prepared for you. And if you have not accepted the gift of salvation that comes from Jesus Christ, I encourage you to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior. You can do so by simply slipping your hand up in the air. You say, I want to give my life today. I've been outside too long, and I'm ready to come into the fold of God and receive the abundance of blessings that God has for me as one of God's children. If you're here today and you want to make that confession, just lift your hand up in the air. Stand up on your feet. I'll meet you in the aisle. We just want to pray with you and help you to receive all that God has promised in God's word for you. And my second call is this. If you're here today and you say, well, I'm already saved. I've already given my life to Christ, but I need a church home. I'm looking for a place where I can grow and learn and be nurtured as a disciple of Jesus Christ. If you're here today and you want to make the New Beginnings United Methodist Church your church home, your place to grow and learn and flourish, we welcome you. My sisters and my brothers, we welcome you in God's house. This can be your church home here today. Amen. Are there any? Then let us prepare our hearts to receive the Holy Sacrament. The litany is printed in your bulletin. If you would please prepare to read along.
Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory, forever and ever. God's precious gift of blood, the life source that offers us life eternal. It is poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. You may partake. Now, God, as we have received of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus, pour out your Spirit to fill our hearts and minds that we may go forward, God, to be your body in the earth, serving, blessing, shining light in dark places. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Well, I pray that you have been blessed today and that you have enjoyed your time in worship. Again, I want to say thank you. It's been a pleasure having each of you in worship today as we celebrate the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I pray that as you prepare to go from this place, that you would go forth in the power of the resurrection, embracing every promise, every hope, every sentiment of joy that God has offered for you.
Amen.
It is yours. I have one quick announcement. I want to remind you, if you didn't get a chance this morning, you may have noticed that there was one group that did not present today in worship. When I was younger and going to church, I had about three friends, and they called us the Fabulous Four. Well, I want to tell y'all, we have a fantastic five here at the New Beginnings United Methodist Church. And if you want to check out the work of the Fantastic Five, you can go to YouTube or Facebook, click on the link, Level Up, and Easter Explanation to see what some of our young men are offering as their expression today in worship and celebration of who Jesus is and what Jesus does in the lives of people all across the world. Amen?
Amen.
Let us prepare our hearts to receive our offering. Sister Eula, is this your grandson?
What?
This your grandson?
My grandson?
Yes. Amen. Come on up here. I'm going to give y'all some rules. Great grandson.
Right.
Man, they came together. I love this. Beautiful. Want to turn around? you in church on Easter Sunday morning. Everybody look.
Amen. Amen.
Y'all clap. And we celebrate you all for bringing him to worship.
Amen. Amen.
We celebrate you all for bringing him to worship. Now, I called y'all up here because when people bring their newborn babies to church,
okay,
don't jump in their baby's faces. Don't grab their baby's hands. You have seen the King right here. Don't grab his head, don't touch his face, any of that. Wait and say, oh, he's so handsome, from your seat. So his mom and dad don't have to bless you in the house of the Lord.